Wells Fargo Minnesota Sports Prep Update for Wednesday, January 29th. I'm Ryan Phelps.
Basically, it's conference scheduling. It's just the state high school is going to tell you who your conference is, because then you're going to go back to that conference and make up your own conference schedule, which they're calling district schedule.
And so it passes, as Brett Schmidt, activities director at Hawley High School in northwestern Minnesota, just explained. Starting in 2015, Minnesota high school football will have district scheduling. The plan was approved by a 19-1 vote at the league's board of directors meeting yesterday in Brooklyn Center before an unusually large crowd of speakers and observers. But as Schmidt explains, while it will help a lot of schools out there who are struggling to fill an 8-game schedule, it won't have much of an impact in Hawley.
Absolute non-issue for us. We've always had 14 teams. We actually now in Hard Lakes Conference have a 16-team conference. So we have 7 conference games, and we all cross over and play a non-conference game at the beginning.
A recent survey showed 41% of schools had problems scheduling games in the past 10 years. So now with district scheduling, teams will be grouped into 22 to 26 districts based primarily on geography and enrollment. Teams will decide upon opponents and build 2-year schedules. And League Associate Director Kevin Merkel expects to complete placement of teams by April 1st. And again, this will take place in the fall of 2015, the same year that the entire football season statewide starts 1 week earlier. Yes, the board also approved that measure, guaranteeing every team 8 regular season games and a playoff spot. Practices will begin August 10th, and the first games will be played August 22nd.
I like saving money. I mean, it's not like I have a purse stuffed with coupons or... Okay, I do. The other day, I went into Wells Fargo to get help with a car loan.
Good news. You qualify for our double discount promotion. Get double the interest rate discount we normally give on select new loans and lines of credit just for being a Wells Fargo checking package customer.
And the best part? I didn't even need a coupon.
Come to Wells Fargo to discuss how the double discount promotion can help with the interest rate on your new loan or line of credit. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far. Subject to credit qualification. Wells Fargo Bank N.A. Equal housing lender.
I'm in a state of caffeination. Got all my fingers shaking. Must have been my large Americano, mochaccino, macchiato. Now the family's gone to bed, and that's my favorite time to get some tips on better rates. Cause my State Farm guy answers late, and even when it's not my agent, someone's standing by so patient. Getting coverage questions answered helps me to relax. Get to a better state, State Farm.
Visit Brandy Warmbier's State Farm Insurance Office, located off Singletree and Flying Cloud Drive, online at brandywarmbier.com.
After last Thursday's High School League Board of Directors meeting, we discussed the changes to the 2015 football schedule and discussed what the new district scheduling will look like. But there were a few items we didn't have time for. We'll get to those today. Sticking with football, a new change is coming that may have a trickle-down effect not only to other classes but perhaps other sports. In Class 6A football, there are 32 teams. It's the 32 largest schools in the state, with the exception of just a few. In the future, all 32 schools will be seeded within each of the 4 sections. Then the seeds would be placed into one of several predetermined but unannounced brackets that would have 16 teams on each side, playing 2 rounds down to 8 teams that would qualify for the state tournament. Top seeds from one section would be paired with an 8th seed from another section, and so on. A 64-team state basketball tournament proposal has been declined a few times in recent years, but follows a similar format with some slight modifications. Other changes that came out of the High School League Board of Directors meeting last Thursday, an expansion was approved for the girls' state fast-pitch softball tournament. They've switched from 3 to now 4 classes. According to the league synopsis, the proposal from the Sports Advisory Committee would still allow the state tournament to be conducted over just 2 days and still allow for consolation play. League staff members indicated that other sport advisory groups interested in adding a class are awaiting the board's decision, including girls volleyball and baseball. So I would expect to see a 4th class added to each of those sports in the coming years. The next board meeting is scheduled for April 3rd. In other news, dynasty is a word we hear often in sports, particularly at the high school level, where certain towns and communities gravitate toward one sport, as is the case for boys swimming and diving at St. Thomas Academy. On Saturday, for the 10th year in a row, the cadets were crowned the boys' small school true team champion, and it was a landslide. More than 600.7 separated them from Northfield in second place. Beyond that, it was a little closer as Breck Blake took third, Sartell St. Stephen in fourth, and Simley took home fifth. Leading the way for St. Thomas Academy was junior Sam Johans, as he took home first in the 50-yard freestyle, edging out Ian Christofferson from Austin, whose Packers, by the way, finished seventh, just 5 points behind Mankato West. In Class 2A, Eden Prairie was looking for their third in a row at the True Team State Meet, but instead the top honors go to Minnetonka, followed by Stillwater. The True Team format is meant to determine the top overall team rather than individuals. It's also used in track and field in addition to swimming and diving. Minnesota began using a True Team format to determine the top high school track and field team in 1987. Boys swimming and diving was added in 2005. The Minnesota State High School League Boys Swimming and Diving State Meet will be held February 27th, 28th, and March 1st at the U of M Aquatic Center.
Your first word probably wasn't something like finance or savings or ATM. But whatever that first word was, it opened up a world to you that was built on conversations. It's this exchange of ideas that Wells Fargo puts into practice every day through listening, guiding, and planning. So when the conversation is about ways to grow your savings or your business, we'll be here to help you find the right answers. Because an open dialogue is what opens doors. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far. Wells Fargo Bank N.A.
Don't underestimate the value of portable heat this winter. Pick up a portable propane heater from Mr. Heater, and the heat will follow wherever you go. Mr. Heater's propane heater warms 800 square feet and can run up to 12 hours on a 20-pound tank. Surround yourself with warmth with a Mr. Heater portable propane heater from Hardware Hank.
You've got a lot more going for you with Hank Hardware.
It's time for our Hardware Hank Nuts and Bolts Athletes of the Week, which are selected every Tuesday based on your nominations to MinnesotaScores.net. Each week we select two winners, one from the Metro and one from Greater Minnesota. The Outstate winner is Ian Christofferson from Austin Boys Swimming and Diving. And the Metro winner is Tia Albert from Tartan Girls Basketball. The Wells Fargo Minnesota Sports Prep Update can be heard right here every Monday through Friday. And for more coverage, you can find us on the web at MinnesotaScores.net. That's Minnesota-Scores.net. I'm Ryan Phelps on Minnesota Sports Radio.
It's time for another round of live local play-by-play coverage of Southwest Metro High School sports. Tonight's broadcast is brought to you by The Mulch Store, Performance Therapy Innovations, Alpha Investment Advisors, The Tavern on 4 and 5, The Sun Current, Home Video Studio, and in partnership with BECTV, Bloomington Educational Cable Television. Catch all of the action all season long on your home for Southwest Metro Sports, PSB Media. Game Time is coming up next.
Welcome on into Braemar Ice Arena here in Edina as we're getting ready for Eden Prairie versus Edina Hockey here on PSB Media. Still about 3 minutes away from the drop of the puck as we're teaming up with 105.7 The Ticket for this evening game here on PSB. So glad to have you with us for this big rivalry matchup. We'll go ahead and take a brief timeout, and when we come back, we'll turn things over to your announcers for tonight's game. That's Pete Wagner and Mr. Bart Archer. They're on the way next right here on PSB.
The playoffs are looming, and the impact of the regular season can take a toll on the body. At Performance Therapy Innovations, they can treat you or your Eagles for those nicks and ailments and help restore athletes physically and mentally for the most important time of the season. Performance Therapy Innovations will get you back to doing the things you love while minimizing your discomfort and maximizing your performance. Performance Therapy Innovations, helping Eagle athletes unleash their full potential. Located off Valley View Road and 169, online at pti-tc.com.
There are many ways to get fit at Healthy Training. Ellie Johnson spilled.
We're speaking with Rob Friend at the Mulch Store. Rob, once people have finished up trimming those trees or raking those leaves, how easy is it for them to stop in at the Mulch Store to drop off those materials or maybe even pick up some mulch for next year.
Well, if you want to stop in and drop off, you come in, check in at the gate attendant, and they'll point you in the right direction after you pay a small fee. And if you're ready to pick up something to do a final garden or mulch project, pick out the product you want, pay for the fee, and we'll load up a trailer or a pickup truck if you have that. If not, we do have delivery available.
And of course, you guys have locations all over the metro area.
That's right. For locations and more information on delivery, you can check us out at our website, mulchstoremn.com.
Just fine. They're going to be hurt from, but obviously when somebody leaves mid here, that puts them in kind of a tough position.
A predicament, as we like to say.
Yes.
Hornets are about to step out on the ice. 1:25 to go on the clock. The Eagles are already there.
Hey, Weston, you are running that bad boy right over there.
We're going to go get them, boys. The Eagles are wearing their black jerseys with white numbers and red trim.
But he's maintained the attitude of his team, and that's why they're having the success of late the game.
I'll fix it.
from center ice. It's sent right back into the Edina zone. And it's going to be Foos with it. Sam Foos quickly outlets left wing side. Submarine on the check was Henry Bowlby. Now it's going to be a strike to play back in off the glass in the corner. Eagles, Andy Aguilar takes over, cuts back to his left, finds his man in Brady Shue, but his pass is picked off by Fiddler. Now Lawrence for the Eagles. Sidesteps one would be Checker. He's going to dump it in deep as they chase with Spinner to the left wing corner. Eagles working the offensive zone. Now it's going to be Spinner to bump neatly back for Graham. Up high to the point. One-timer. That one wide of the cage. That went off roll call even though it was wide and up and out of play.
Well, that was a good shot by junior defenseman Mark Sullivan on that one. Just got it and fired one-timer. Went blocker side and roll call knew he made the serve, but I think he lost track of where that puck went. But really good zone entry by Cole Lawrence. Dumped into the far corner. They were able to catch up with it, but he kind of had their big line on there, and they're back on their heel speed.
Indeed they are, Bart Archer. The Eagles with a little bit of jump to their step. A little more purpose to this one. I think you know, we saw them a couple months ago here at Braemar Arena looking pretty darn tired by the time that third game of the Holiday Classic came through. With the lack of school these teams have had, I'm sure they're well rested, probably bored. First time I ever heard my kids say, Bart, I want to get back to school.
Wow.
Back in behind the net. Curtis was set up behind the Eden Prairie net. Now it's Spinner walks down the left wing side. They're going to play up high to the line. Graham is there as he gets inside and battles the Hornets. Garrett Waite. Lawrence is stood up neatly by Bellows. Couple sophomores do battle. Now Zielsdorf for Bellows, left wing. He's going to have to hurry. His oncoming was Mark Sullivan. The turnover ensues. You heard a little pile up right there. You radio land right to our ice, Mike. Good stuff there. Right in front of the penalty box area. Snuggerud on the tape. Argensinger. He's poke checked neatly by Zielsdorf. 12:50 to go. Period number one. No score. By the way, don't forget to check out the Let's Play Hockey Player of the Game. We'll have that for you at the end of tonight's contest. In addition, we're going to have the Premier Goaltender Development Save of the Game. Bart Archer is going to come up with a bank, and we'll get a check for you next week.
We'll probably
get that sponsor, will you?
We'll probably have plenty of choices tonight as well, Pete.
Snuggerud looks to the right, to the left. Neat little pass off the right wing wall. That was too far. Nice stiff check thrown by Safgren as he walked up the wall. He'll come away with it across the line. Snapshot blocker pad. Looked like it took Rolko by surprise. Kind of handcuffed him to the right corner. Puck is shoveled up to the line. Left point. That's Shue to play in for the Eagles. Now out of the zone comes Howe. That pass too far for the speedy Cullen Rosh. Back into the Edina zone it goes. Left side roll call. 11:59 to go. No score.
Yeah, in fact, it's been a pretty good pace so far. I think, as you said, Petey, Prairie has energy tonight with focus. Energy can only go so far, but if you don't have focus, then you're going to waste energy. So far, they look like they're completely on point. They're putting Edina. They're challenging Edina and forcing them to make plays, and that's what I think Lee Smith wants.
Played back down behind the net. Nanny looked to his right. He's going to speed up the left wing side. Nice little house. She going on the stick handle. The skills on full display just offside of the right wing was Matt Master. But the Hornets, a little jumpy there on the Eagle blue line, will bring it back to center ice.
Yeah, and it really negates all the good work. Nanny dangling through traffic to get out of the zone, got it up. But it just Masterman preceded by more than just a step lead. If you have an offensive opportunity, the quickest way to stop it is to go offside faceoff just outside the Prairie zone.
Eagles will play for Lawrence, but stepping over is Paul Meyer. Gets some help from Fiddler, plays the puck inside. Oh, that one deflected for the trolling. Munson, that's wide of the cage, and they're going to battle off the right wing wall with the puck played up by the Eagles through center. Cross the checkered line and in deep for Mark Sullivan as that's in on goal, and it's going to be hung on to by Andrew Rolko.
Well, the neutral zone's a little muddy right now. Both teams are trying to mount their charge about the red line, and both teams in good positioning, so he's pretty content to just dump it in. They're not going for the opposite corner. They're dumping it on goal. Rokal decided to hold on and get some fresh legs out there. 11:22 left in the scoreless first period. Faceoff to Rokal's right.
Boy, we got a very good musical mix here at Braemar Arena from our public address announcer, Dave Langholtz. He took me back to the mid-90s with that last one. I'm sure some bad basketball movie or something. Snugger who goes behind the back in his own zone to the right side for Shu, who angles a pass, but Nanny makes a nice play. Pulls that away from Jack Sullivan in his own zone. Nanny bites the dust, falls, loses, and Keeley plays up for Shu right point. Eagles with an opportunity off Bellows and a souvenir up in the stands.
Yeah, and I think that stunk Bellows a little bit. I think he got him just on top of the shin pad down in that soft area.
Too.
He doesn't look any worse for the wear, but boy, he bumped that one right away. But pretty good opportunity by Detroit. They just looked at that shot and go face off. Now the wear falls left. But keeper Bellows has really not showed up on the score sheet as much as I think that he would like to, but he's been a very competent forward on this team, and it's a really nice line with Wade Malmquist and Bellows as well. One of the formidable lines for this Edina Hornets team.
Bellows had a torrid start to the campaign, still has 18 points on it as a sophomore. Moved up a grade. Usually guys these days are moving back a grade, but he came in his freshman year here and just started right in at the sophomore year.
How about that?
Kind of a rarity.
A little fun fact.
Absolutely. You can get that only here on Sports Radio 105, the ticket. Now it's Spindler with a nice play off the wall to himself. He had energy to the net. Curtis goes down prematurely. Didn't matter. Puck is wide. Big hit on the wall. As that was Snuggerud, Masterman, and Fiddler coming together as they'll battle off the left wing as the Eagles look to break out of their own zone. Hornets continue to make things difficult in the offensive zone on the forecheck. Fiddler comes off the wall, walks in, save Curtis. He covers and hangs on.
Well, Luke Snugger was a one-man wrecking ball down in the corner, taking out Fiddler and Masterman by himself and having some pretty good success. He got eventually prevailed in that possession game, but got it out front. And it was Fiddler who got the initial shot, tried to drag the goalie out. Munson on the follow-up, but he played in a good job of getting in tight and protecting the goaltender. No harm, no foul. Face-off to his left.
And back behind the Eden Prairie net. Hornets work the offensive zone. And up ice they go. Poke check neatly by the Hornets defense. That's Foose. Sam Foose, very slick skating, puck-moving defenseman for the Edina club. Has a great future ahead of him. Body check thrown from the right side by Aguilar as he stands up. Bowlby dead in his tracks. And Eagles get the turnover. But Poole keyed right back into the Eagles zone. Neatly at the point on the left side by Foley. At center ice, they'll try to play that through traffic. Neat play, Argensinger. Right wing side from the hash marks. Backing in as Rocco makes the save. That got messy in a hurry there, Bart Archer.
Well, Argensinger is a junior, but he did a good job coming in on the right side. Just on top of the circle, he let one go for a pretty shallow angle. But Rocco struggled with that one a little bit. Kind of struggled with the rebound, and then he probably charged the goal. And then came up the moorings on the north side of Braemar Arena. You never see that.
Not
it happened this
there.
Time. But a pretty good opportunity by Argensinger in the Prairie Eagles.
Malmquist to lean in on the draw as he gets picked by Parrish, and the Eagles with a chance off the end line and a save made by Rocco. Nanny comes away with it. Great face-off work by Lee Smith's Eden Prairie Eagles as they maintain possession in the offensive zone. We've heard so much about the Minnesota Wild and when they were losing or struggling for their face-off woes and what it means to be chasing the game in the biscuit. Off the glass it goes, back into the Edina zone, though they can't clear as Nanny will try to work for the right wing breakout, sliding down his weight. He's going to have to go right back behind the net, and he'll now outlet to the left winger, Bellows, who has that one read like a book and fired right back in by Sullivan. Hornets cannot break the zone here on this shift. 8 minutes and 38 seconds to go. The Eagles with a trapping forecheck, much like the one employed by the Hopkins Royals last week that gave the Hornets all sorts of trouble. Not to the tune of a 7-1 win, but nonetheless, the Hornets had to work hard to get through that.
Oh, indeed.
Spinner sprung on the left wing. He can fly it on goal. Roar! A play by Meyer. Slides through the slot area and breaks up the Steven Spinner bid. That was a beauty play there. Spinner gets it back. His shot blocked again by Meyer. A memorable shift for number two on the Edina Hornets on the blue line. Bellows now exhausted across center. Is going to try and create anyway and not head of the bench. And now it's going to be Spinner who will turn it back up ice. Look out. Here come the Eagles. Parrish plays back. Check that. That was Graham, rather, that played over the right wing side for Mark Sullivan. Right back into the Edina zone. There's a stick that comes into play. It always does. The extra twig. It's like these guys don't see it in their feet. I swear. It's a given. It always happens. Off the corner. Now Fiddler plays for Munch. The Eagles have really had a nice run of opportunities here for the past 3 or 4 minutes of this contest. Behind the net it goes. Pinching down the wall. Safgren was there. Fiddler bothers him. Takes the loose puck to the slot. Tries to slice through the defense, but the Eagles carve him up like a turkey on Thanksgiving Day. Snuggerud plays that one back in to the corner. Goose is there. Checked. Behind the net it goes. Argutsinger up to shoot. Left point. Eagles offensive zone. Right point now. Snapper by Snuggerud. Hits traffic. Rolling puck through the slot. Where is it? That hits Rocco on its way in. Ooh, three great opportunities that we can count on right now in the past 2 minutes. Back up high to Shue. Shue to the right side. Snuggerud, oh, dangles on Munch and sends him packing. Now Shue, a shot and a pad save made by Rocco. Back up to Shue, left point. You can feel it, Bart Archer. There's a shot on goal. Rebound. Rocco, another save. All kinds of things going on with that one.
Well, he's down on the ropes right now. He's really showing some great energy, but the angles of the forecheck, Pete, the angles of attack, and then the puck support coming is really creating fits for Edina trying to get out of those zones. And subsequently, Edina can get up between the hash marks and put some pressure on Rocco. Edina basically in a bend but don't break mode, but you can feel something coming. Eden Prairie showing great poise and great energy right now.
That's going to be Meyer, who plays to the left wing side. Submarining the would-be check there was Howe. And from center, oh, that hits traffic. And it's going to be played back in behind. Up high at the blue line, the Eagles once again will play it through at the Edina zone. Batted down with 6:08 to go in the first. A big shot to fire that one back in from the center red by Mark Sullivan. Hornets again working out of their own zone. Now it's going to be Rosh up ice. Cullen Ross tries to slice through traffic, and instead it's Lawrence to make the play. Nifty little backhand pass for Graham, who gets it on stride across the Edina line. Hornets pack it in defensively. Nice check thrown by Haug on Graham, but still, the Eagles maintain possession, and that is in off the mask of Rocco. A quick wrist shot that fooled the Edina goaltender from Luke Snuggerud. Now it's Spinner feeling it to the low slot, off the stick of Lawrence. Snuggerud reads it, gets it, shoots it, pad save it a beauty. Andrew Rocco twice called on to make some saves again.
Yeah, there's been a lot of breakdowns in the Edina zone, and that's just a result of a lot of hard work by the Eden Prairie forwards. They're really putting pressure on the Edina defenders, and they're making plays before they're ready to. And subsequently, the puck gets on Snuggerud's stick, which is what Eden Prairie doesn't mind at all. But he let a shot go, and as you said, Peter, went off his mask, but the Edina very fortunate. They dodged a couple bullets. Shots on goal right now, Eden Prairie 9, Edina only 4, and that's kind of indicative to how this game has unfolded so far.
Oh, another blocker pad saved by roll call. The shots are mounting now. Eden Prairie was trailing dramatically in that category. It's now 10-9, Bart Archer?
It's 10-4.
Wait with it. Snapper, that one tried to go high short side, and that was denied at the door. Didn't get through. Up and out of play.
Well, at least an encouraging sign is Garrett Wade on the off wing, a left-handed shot on the right wing on top of the right circle. One of the goals offside, but I don't know if actually Gertis deflected it or if it just went off in up and out of play. But face up now to Gertis's left, but at least he's kind of showing a little life on the offensive side, Pete.
Puck will be played up to Plays on the left wing side. He'll turn and play to Shue as he gains the center red. 3-on-3 at the line. The Eagles back to work in the offensive zone. Argutsinger checked on the play. He tries to fish it. It's Zuhlsdorf with the body on him. In to help out, it's Malmquist down low. He stood up on the play. Foose will take over for the Hornets out of the zone. Bellows left wing on the pass. Tries to get through Snuggerud. Can't do it. And Snuggerud will play this back up for Malmquist. To the low slot area. Waite will take the loose change off the wall. Swatted away by Shue and on the stick neatly there out of the zone. Safgren is there off the glass and down. New addition to the lineup here for Lee Smith and Safgren, and he's been doing a nice job.
Yeah, he really has. In fact, he's a junior forward playing up in tough situations, but it's nice to have that kind of depth that you can roll him out and not miss a beat. But Edina in the line of Malmquist, Waite, and Bellows putting a little offensive pressure on. Actually, Edina has an offensive zone faceoff to Gertis' right, but and they win the draw as well. The ebbs and flows, Pete Wagner.
It's a really solid textured ice hockey game between these two teams and on goal. Curtis makes the save. It's going to be dragged out of the zone by Keeley, who said, let's go. To Paul Meyer just goes right out of the body, and they keep coming. In on goal, and there's a save made by Rocco. Bart Archer, the first opportunity was a great look by the Hornets, and then back come the Eagles.
Yeah, and I think Keeley with the speed, I think he surprised the Edina defender, trying to challenge him at the move, and they kept moving forward. And Keeley and Parrish actually got in tight, but Rocco, good decision to make a save on that one. Get a whistle, let Edina settle themselves down.
And we're back underway as the Hornets take it to the left wing. Offensive zone. Munson from a shallow angle. Save made by Curtis. Poked to the corner. Munson will swap that off the glass. It's pulled really off the helmet. Sullivan was there to pull it away from the right winger there and somehow played it to center. Now it's going to be Nanny with it. Long pass through center, picked off by the busy stick of number 25, Steven Spitter. Lawrence now will work the offensive zone, back behind for Graham. Fiddler is on him. Spinner there as well. Now Nanny comes away with it. Outlets to the left wing side for Munson. On the move, up and out of play. Look out. We'll face off at center.
Well, good pace of this game. A lot of up and down action. Ypres obviously pushing the pace, but Edina closing the shots on goal 10-7 now. Edina showing some life. But Eden Prairie just keeps coming and coming and coming. And I think these Edina Hornet defenders are showing a little red in their cheeks. I think they're working off a heartbeat. I don't know if they're quite used to this pace. But they've done a pretty good job of defending. We have zeros on the scoreboard. 3:12 left in the scoreless first period.
Good to see Andrew Nealand listening on. Checking out the game here. There's a shot that doesn't work its way through. It's swatted away there by Snugger. 3 minutes exactly remaining in a very fast-moving first period. Here from lovely Braemar Arena. Shoe shot buzzed wide of the cage. Argetsinger walks down. Gets a little bit of help off the boards with Clays, but there's Bellows patiently to pull it away. He hits a pair of shins and Clays, who stands him up, and the puck is rappelled right back into the Edina zone. Wait with it now. Angles a pass for Malmquist. Left wing side for Bellows in stride. Snuggery just moves his stick in his right hand, the left-hand shot, just deflects that one right up off the netting and out of play.
Well, and I don't know if it's by design, but Luke Snuggery is not giving Bellows any room whatsoever. He's on him in a hurry. Spacing and pacing, obviously very important in this game, but Snuggery really keen to play tonight. All phases of his game seem to be firing in the right areas.
Big games can bring out the best in some players and the worst, and in this case, we're seeing a ton out of Spinner and Snuggery.
Yeah, Nebraska Omaha is getting a couple pretty good players, Pete.
Absolutely. Dean Blaze, he's got Avery Peterson. He does have Avery Peterson working down there. Jake Randolph is running the show as your leading point getter in the USHL. I think it's fair to say that some of the local colleges might have been sleeping a little bit.
Well, and Dean Blaze has always been, he'll outwork everybody, but just the fact of getting him to commit takes a certain kind of a flair, and he certainly has been able to do that.
Hey, if Dean Blaze knocks on your door and your Division I son capable, I think the answer is a pretty quick yes.
Well, you want to at least hear.
Look at the body of work.
No question.
Behind the net it goes. Left wing for Munson, too far. That gets underneath the stick of Andy Aguilar. No ice on the play. 1:57 to go in the period. Fiddler got shivered. Lost his glove, and no surprise there wasn't a penalty called, was the Edina center iceman. Parrish leaves for Lawrence up the right wing, wide of the cage. It'll be picked up by Parrish off the carom. Behind the net they go as Edina defensive coach Dave Langevin shouts instructions to his defensive four. Through center they go with Munson. Neat little play to the right wing side. Gets some support with Masterman. Tried to dance around the defense, but Aguilar stayed patient and calm on that one. Took the angle away. Snuggerud outlets Lawrence through center to play back in deep behind the United net. It's going to be Meyer playing that one back up on the left wing side, but there to cut it off, it's Michael Parrish. Offside is the call, and they'll bring the faceoff outside the zone.
Well, I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in and joining us for Lake Conference action tonight. Really kind of been a muddy first period. Not a lot of opportunities, but a lot of up and down. And that just means that there's a lot of effort, but positioning is pretty good. Edina's holding true, and they're not chasing Eden Prairie around, so they're making at least Eden Prairie work, but Eden Prairie obviously has the better chances this period to push at the pace still, Pete.
Special hello to Mark Austin watching on.
Hello, Mark.
Appreciate it. And it'll be handled by the Hornets as it's picked off of the line. The Eagles, a snapper blocked by Paul Meyer. He's going to be a walking bruise by the time this thing's over. Fortunately, he won't look like a peach. It's going to be Snuggery now walking to the top. Lets a shot go, and at the last minute, it was the goaltender, Andrew Rollcall, to see that and made a nice save to turn that aside.
Yeah, he had to make a really good save. It was a good shot on goal. It seemed to have eyes. Made it to be Edina goaltender, but there were three furry forwards there to look for a rebound. Edina's got to do a better job of blocking out. They did do a good job of letting the goaltender see it, but they have to at least block out, so if there is a second chance, they at least make them earn it. But if it was a loose rebound, it might have been 1-0 each period. 4-4.2 left in this scoreless first period.
Well, Jossa for the loose puck. We're excited for the section playoffs. Big announcement coming up in the next week or so regarding those. Through center ice it goes. This is going to be possibly, in Bart, my opinion, one of the most memorable playoff seasons, as the parity of these teams statewide is so good, and we can't really say where a state champion is going to come from. We used to be able to say it's going to come from the 2 or 6. That's not the case this year.
No, I think you're right. In fact, it might even come from section 1 as it stands right now, Pete. But all sections are going to be represented.
Ooh, foreshadowing the Panthers.
But I just think that it's anybody's ball game, and what that means is even the teams that are in the 4 and 5 seed are going to play with extra energy because they know that the path is in their hands. They just have to go out and get it.
Off the glass in the offensive zone. Munson peels from the left wing, poked away from him. Zulsdorf with 17 seconds plays behind the net. Munson tries to center off the right side of the cage to Fiddler, but that hits an Eagle player, and it's going to be Snuggerud back up the right wing for Argent. Singer, Zulsdorf off the wall. Snuggerud to the read with 3 to go from the right circle. Shoots! Oh, that one off the side of the net. That was very close, Bart Archer.
Boy, that was some great athleticism by Snuggerud on that one. Drew the Edina defenders to his right. Put the puck back to the left. Got a pretty good shot. Wasn't on goal, but when Snuggerud is playing his game, he can get the puck out of his own quick and get some shots on goal. So far, he can check both of those boxes. But Eden Prairie has to feel pretty good about the way that they played that period, Pete. They took the play to the Edina Hornets, made them defend, and Edina really bore in the reactive mode. If you can get Edina skating backwards, it's a lot better than having them skate forwards against you. That's for sure, but going to be an interesting second period, no question.
Indeed it is. This is the high school hockey game of the week. You're listening to Sports Radio 105, The Ticket.
I wish it was spring.
Hello, Carl.
Whoa, who are you?
I'm the Mulch Store Genie.
Well, your entrance music makes you sound like an alien.
We Mulch Store Genies survive on grass and compost, not snow and ice.
If you're a genie, where's your lamp?
Mulch Store Genies live. Never mind you. Let's get to the point. You had a wish for me, Carl.
Yeah, I wished it would be spring.
Your wish is my command.
Sweet! This is much better. Wow, my lawn looks great too.
Indeed, Carl. That's the power of the Mulch Store Genius.
Thanks.
Tell your friends of my mulching powers.
The Mulch Store. Granting beautiful lawn and landscaping wishes since 2000. Store locations in Burnsville, Minnetrista, Rosemount, and Shakopee.
Great food and great sports. It's the Tavern on 4 and 5 in Eden Prairie. This season, the Tavern on 4 and 5 will be showing several PSB broadcasts of Eden Prairie boys hockey on the big screen TVs. So make it a night out. Get some great food and watch the EP boys hockey team at the Tavern on 4 and 5. Some of their classics include the Mediterranean Pizza, the Tavern Turkey Burger, and my personal favorite, the Cheesy Tater Tots. It's the Tavern on 4 and 5, located just blocks from Eden Prairie High School.
I'm Dr. Ness Lenslink, clinic administrator and patient care coordinator for AdvoCare Clinics. And I'd like to welcome you to our office. AdvoCare Clinics is considered an outpatient rehabilitation facility. We're pretty much one-stop shop. We offer wellness and prevention as well as acute pain and injury management. We have three distinct departments in AdvoCare. We have a physical therapy department, a chiropractic, wellness and prevention, and acupuncture department, and a medical procedure department. And the unique characteristic is how we combine those therapies. Our goal is to prevent surgeries or conditions getting worse. So one of our specialties is knee, hip, ankle, shoulder problems. where people are considering surgery. Many times we can then provide care that'll buy them 5 to 10 years of ongoing function with their original equipment, their own joints and shoulders. Our patients tell us that they like the attention to detail that we deliver in our therapies. Most of our patients give us a 7-plus score on a 1 to 10 scale, which means we're meeting a good amount of patient satisfaction based on your scores. Avacare's mission is to provide you a full and active lifestyle to the limits that you want, not what your body gives you.
Avacare Clinics, located off 494 and Highway 100, online at avacaremn.com.
I think I have the window seat.
You better double check that, my friend.
Don't think we don't know who you are.
Yeah, I'm Aaron Rodgers.
No, that's not it. You're that State Farm discount double check guy.
Discount double check. Thanks to the hundreds you saved us, we could upgrade the grill class.
Grill class?
Your tongs are in your seat back.
Save with the discount double check today.
Discount double check.
Get to a better state, State Farm.
Guys, this is my cousin Raj.
Hey, boys, I just saved a ton of cash with my State Farm discount
double check.
So the brats are on me.
Oh, jeez.
Crazy dream.
Easy. You're going to wreck Bob's dream. By the way, how's that sausage pillow?
Delicious cod stick.
Save with the discount double check today. Get to a better state, State Farm.
Shop and save with Brandy Warmbier State Farm Insurance Office in Eden Prairie, a local connection at a lower cost. BrandyWarmbier.com.
Welcome back here to Braemar Ice Arena in Edina. Brett Johnson here in the broadcast booth between periods. Interesting first period, really dominated by Eden Prairie, keeping possession in the Hornet zone, but they don't have anything to score for it or show for it on the score sheet yet as we remain scoreless. We'll have to see how things play out in the second period. And Eden Prairie's not had a whole lot of success against Edina over the years here at Braemar. Just one win over the past six seasons here at Braemar. One of those, though, was, of course, last season when Eden Prairie won the season finale 3-1 over the Hornets right here at the rink right off 169 Valley View Road. I'd like to remind you our broadcast tonight brought to you by the Mulch Store, Performance Therapy Innovations, the Tavern on 4 and 5, and also Advocare Clinics of Minnesota. I'd like to thank all of them for bringing you coverage here tonight of a great matchup between Eden Prairie and Edina. As you've heard Pete and Bart say, both these teams rated among the top 10 and a lot of Lake Conference implications on the line. Of course, coming up on Saturday, we'll have coverage of Eden Prairie versus Wayzata Hockey here on PSB Media. Be another big Lake Conference battle. Make sure you tune in for that coming up Saturday at 7 o'clock. We'll go ahead and take another brief timeout and take a look at some out-of-town scores up next here on PSB.
We're speaking with Rob Friend at the Mulch Store. Rob, once people have finished up trimming those trees or raking those leaves, how easy is it for them to stop in at the Mulch Store to drop off those materials? Or maybe even pick up some mulch for next year.
Well, if you want to stop in and drop off, you come in, check in at the gate attendant, and they'll point you in the right direction after you pay a small fee. And if you're ready to pick up something to do a final garden or mulch project, pick out the product you want, pay for the fee, and we'll load up a trailer or a pickup truck if you have that. If not, we do have delivery available.
And of course, you guys have locations all over the metro area.
That's right. For locations and more information on delivery, you can check us out at our website, mulchstoremn.com.
The playoffs are looming, and the impact of the regular season can take a toll on the body. At Performance Therapy Innovations, they can treat you or your Eagles for those nicks and ailments and help restore athletes physically and mentally for the most important time of the season. Performance Therapy Innovations will get you back to doing the things you love while minimizing your discomfort and maximizing your performance. Performance Therapy Innovations, helping Eagle athletes unleash their full potential. Located off Valley View Road and 169, online at pti-tc.com.
Welcome back to Braemar Ice Arena. Let's take a look at some out-of-town scores before we get you ready here for the second period. Not too much else to pass along to you. We have Elk River on top of Maple Grove, 2-0. Also have Monticello leading Northfield, 2-0. And St. Michael Albertville on top of St. Cloud Tech, 1-0. Achiever Academy leads Dodge County 5-1. Buffaloes over Red Lake Falls 3-1. And in terms of other scores, that is about it, as our team's not quite reporting their scores as of yet early here on this Thursday night. Second period is coming up in just a few minutes. Again, Edina and Eden Prairie are scoreless here on PSK Media.
I wish it was spring.
Hello, Carl.
Whoa, who are you?
I'm the Mulch Store Genie.
Well, your entrance music makes you sound like an alien.
We Mulch Store Genies survive on grass and compost, not snow and ice.
If you're a genie, where's your lamp?
Mulch Store Genies live. Never mind you. Let's get to the point. You had a wish for me, Carl.
Yeah, I wished it would be spring.
Your wish is my command.
Sweet! This is much better. Wow, my lawn looks great too.
Indeed, Carl. That's the power of the Mulch Store Genius.
Thanks.
Tell your friends of my mulching powers.
The Mulch Store. Granting beautiful lawn and landscaping wishes since 2000. Store locations in Burnsville, Minnetrista, Rosemount, and Shakopee.
Great food and great sports. It's the Tavern on 4 and 5 in Eden Prairie. This season, the Tavern on 4 and 5 will be showing several PSB broadcasts of Eden Prairie boys hockey on the big screen TVs. So make it a night out. Get some great food and watch the EP boys hockey team at the Tavern on 4 and 5. Some of their classics include the Mediterranean Pizza, the Tavern Turkey Burger, and my personal favorite, the Cheesy Tater Tots. It's the Tavern on 4 and 5, located just blocks from Eden Prairie High School.
Welcome back here to PSB Media. We're going to turn things over to Pete Wagner and Bart Archer, who are going to bring you a second period action right here on PSB Media.
They don't freeze out or anything like that, but they just like to be able to keep them get out of the ice, and then they have their dramatic entrance, but they're going to have to worry less about the dramatic entrance and worry more about their own zone play, because they're certainly Not playing the efficient brand that we're used to seeing out of the Van Hornet team, but again, comes back to praise and eat praise for what they're doing.
You know, I think if you're Lee Smith, Bart, there's nothing you want to change.
Well, maybe, finish a couple. That's about the only thing. But they're playing their old zone has been pretty good as far as Eden Prairie. They haven't had too many. But Edina's a team that can come at you quickly. But Eden Prairie's keeping up with Edina's quick transition hitting. But I think it all starts with the forecheck. Edina's having a pretty difficult time getting out of their zone with speed. And if you can't get out of your zone with speed, the zone becomes the target area. And that's where Eden Prairie's really tight. You can squeeze on this
one. Well, speaking of that very neutral line is, that's where the Burnsville Blaze really exposed the Hornets. They not only took it away, but they dominated it. They took it away defensively, and then they owned it offensively and created their chances and went to work.
And I don't know if this is the proper phrasing, but I think Burnsville kind of broke Edina's spirit, because Edina's always a solid two-way, three-zone team. They became a one-direction team, and that's a credit to the Burnsville Blaze.
Yes, we're underway now to start the second period. We're scoreless. We've solved nothing after 17 minutes of play here for Braemar Arena. It's going to be Munson off the wall. Snuggerud is there. Off the boards, but picked off by Masterman to the right point. Bruce, nice little backhand pass, top of the right circle. That one wide of the cage. Snuggerud will guide it up the wall. Spinner leaves off for Snuggerud across center. Snuggerud will carry deep to the left side as he gets the goaltender moving one way. Roll call and buzzes that one wide of the cage. Now it's going to be Graham. But the confidence of Michael Graham, Bart, in month-to-month increments here this season has been telltale.
He just gets better and better as the season goes on.
Back in behind Edina, and it goes. 45 seconds into the second session. It's going to be Masterman. Sidesteps the plays. Would be stick check to the right wing side across the line. Fiddler to the slot. Buzzes that wide. Curtis waved the magic wand known as the catch glove at that one. Back at center ice it goes. Bruce plays it to Nanny across the line, and that one's offside.
Yeah, that was Bellows that just snuck in. Nanny had a pretty good rush, but it was 2-on-3. We're early in the second period. Still scoreless at this time, but Edina looks like they have a little bit more focus, a little bit more of a sense of purpose. But Luke Snuggerud, once again, Pete, he's a difficult one to contain. That's Edina's challenge right now, is to target Luke Snuggerud and try to limit his game, because he's showing all kinds of speed tonight.
It'll be Meyer with it, who plays back in behind the net. Curtis sets up. Slamming that one along the left wing wall for the Eagles was Mark Sullivan, and they'll work it through center. Across the line they go with Michael Parrish, but the Hornets now thwarting the Eagles' opportunities across the line. Sullivan plays that to his partner. That's Aguilar to center. Keeley was there. Look out, upstairs that one goes as Malmquist wanted to go off the high glass. Work the window pane and bring it into the zone. Instead, it went up as a souvenir about 2 rows from the top.
Yeah, that'll deter some of the texters up there for at least a little period of time. But really pretty good job by Edina to step up at their own blue line, Pete. And they threw the puck back. We appreciate that very much. So we're going to have a mild stoppage. But Pete, the point I was trying to make is the Edina forwards are coming back to help the defenders. They can step up at the blue and actually challenge the Eden Prairie team. That's something they didn't do in the first period.
That one's pushed wide of the cage. Fans, don't forget to check out the Let's Play Hockey Player of the Game as announced by our very own Bart Archer. Also have the Premier Goaltender Development Save the Game as well. Good to see Todd Nealon is in the house. We're in good hands now. Across the line, here comes Malmquist. Malmquist with a look to the corner as he's checked by Snuggerud. And I'm being asked why Malmquist didn't go to Harvard by the alum himself, and I have no answer. He went to Notre Dame. He wants a better education. From center ice, it's off the boards and played back. You know, Bart, I do have to say, I don't think there's a soul in this building that we don't know before this is over.
Yeah, you're being very generous, Pete. You are the person that's
I said me.
I'm just riding coattails, man. I'm a crumb on the plate.
Plays with it. Rink wide he goes for Argent Singer. Foose is watching him closely as Bellows will chip that one through traffic. Wide of the cage to Curtis left it goes. Nice check. Oh, A strike opens up. They score! A strike with a vicious hard check and hands it over to Casey Dornbach, and the Hornets hit the
runner. Well, Dornbach gave him a look at the open stick, but then went pulled it to the backhand, went up and opened the shoulder on that one just under the crossbar. He kind of gets rewarded for a lot of hard work this year, but a bit of a breakdown in the zone. He got an opportunity. music as ever in the North Bank. That just his fourth goal of the year. Doesn't see a lot of ice, but very effective when he gets out there. He gives his team a huge advantage. It'll be interesting to see how the season very quick responds. The goal is out the fourth check of Alec Aistrank, and he threw the puck out to Dornbach in the right circle. The big senior winger is a physical presence as he died a hard in the distance. Ice. It's going to be handed now by Monson as he plays back for Zulsdorf up the left wing wall. Spun off the biscuit was Monson up and into the bench area. The Hornets now score just a couple of minutes into the second period, take the first lead of the game, and really they've thwarted the Eagles' opportunity to the offensive zone and have changed the pace.
It's kind of a bend but don't break, and you get to think in a roll call senior goaltender for Edina. Otherwise, Edina might have just been cutting the lead by a third or a half in that respect. But again, Eden Prairie looks like they're poised. Body language is positive. They just have to keep playing the way they're playing, but they have to start getting some opportunities in the second period, like the first. But the official scoring was Dornbach from a strike at 2:33.
Graham was pickpocketed at the Hornet line by Foose, who wanted to race up the wing and couldn't make the play, and up and out of play, both.
Well, you know, the United defenders, the challenge in front of them is that this Eden Prairie team has some very swift forwards, Steven Spinner being one of them. Really got on top of them in a hurry and deflected that one up and out of play. Faceoff's going to be the roll call's right. But there's a lot of speed on this Eden Prairie team. I think it's undersold as far as how quick they really are. But Steven Spinner is in a different league, really.
I have seen him chase down players on teams where, you know, you can make an argument, get on goal as Rocco makes the save to cover that one. We can make an argument that could be one of the quickest players around, and he chases them all down.
And to take it a step further, Pete, a lot of players can play very fast, but not a lot of players can control the puck while they're playing fast. Steven Spinner can certainly do that.
And shoot it while the feet are still moving.
Indeed. Faceoff to Rocco's right, 13:40 left in the second period. He done up by one. Shots on goal, Eden Prairie 12, Edina 8.
Graham will take the faceoff against Dylan Malmquist. Offensive zone opportunity. Spinner had a great look at the cage and whiff. Looking for Dan Patrick's and the whiff. Wait with it up the right wing side as he's checked on the play to center. Parrish, now Nanny. Checked by Meyer in the boards in front of the penalty box area. Danny backpedals from the right circle, plays the head off the glass for Wade, couldn't handle the biscuit, hit him in the ankles, and it's going to be Spinner to make a nice move around Meyer. Weak side for Graham, poked away from him, and it's going to be Wade off the boards, but that didn't go where he wanted it to. Bounces to the slot area, and they're going to play ahead of Bellows on the left wing. His pass intended for Malmquist, too far. And across center, it's going to be in on goal, and Rocco will make the save. He's going to guide it out of his pads and give it to Danny. From the right wing side, he tries to find his man Aguilar. No ice on the play. Bellows takes the carom and lets a bomb go high and over the top of the goal. From the right point off the board, Zulsdorf, but now the Nautis plays, takes over at center, loses the handle, and it's going to be Mark Sullivan. Aguilar's long pass, deflected by a stick, no ice on the play. Everybody in the rink, player-wise, stood up on that one, waiting for the whistle, and they play on. 12:27 to go, 1-0 Edina here in the second period. Ross plays it rink wide for mismatch. That's poked out of there neatly by the defense. That's Mark Sullivan. And it's off the stick of Gerdes. Sullivan, oh, mishandles, mismatch. Oh, Mr. Opportunistic was there. Had a golden opportunity off the end boards and in on goal.
Yeah, the puck rolled on Mark Sullivan as he tried to go behind his own goal. And it was mismatched. And he just saw a golden opportunity. Nobody between him and Gerdes on that one. Had a bit of a shallow angle, trying to put it on goal, but it went wide. But Eden Prairie is starting to lose their responsibility in their own zone with plays like that. But Sullivan's really done a great job for this team. So just an aberration in that respect, but he's been opportunistic as ever.
The corner goes back in behind the net with the five-minute mark of period number one. Edina leads 1-0. Danny sidesteps to the left, puts on the brakes, looks to the right. Back up to the left point. Oh, look out. That hit Kobe Bull right off the face mask in the bench area as it goes up and out of play with face off at center.
Well, I think his save percentage just increased a little bit. He controlled the rebound pretty well on that one. But, yeah, that was a hit a little bit more velocity. Face off just outside the Prairie zone. Left 52 left in the second period. Edina up by one.
Snuggerud plays ahead. Jack Sullivan with it. Now Keeley, watched by Meyer, who pushes enough of the frame off the puck to force it to go back in behind the Edina net. from the left corner in the Edina zone. It's Nanny with it. Loses the handle. He's going to have to regroup to the right wing. Neat breakout to Masterman. Finds Fiddler. Fiddler had needed about one step extra, but he's a little bit behind Masterman. He had the beautiful touch pass that would have looked like the great late Billy Mork to Paul Ranheim on the breakout.
Wow, now you're tugging at the heartstrings, Pete.
Ooh, goodness. Of course, Bill Mork and the Edina greats back in the 84 state championship died suddenly in a car accident. Remembered by all here at Braemar Arena and his teammates for certain. Masterman with it. Looks to the left wing side off the stick of Munson. Back into the corner it goes. Snuggerud, Munson come together. Nice physical matchup as that one went up in the air and off the netting and out of play.
Yeah, and Fiddler thought he had a golden moment, but pretty good battle by Colin Munson and Luke Snuggerud on that one. Two big bodies going into the wall. Really nothing was decided at that point. But Colin Munson is one of these players. And Munson's got 13 goals on the year. He got a hat trick against a Hopkins team, but he never stops moving his feet. He's very effective when he moves his feet. And the challenge was in Snuggerud, and I think he held pretty well. But Snuggerud and Munson are two big bodies out there battling it out tonight.
And they know each other well. Swatted at, couple of 20s doing battle. Malmquist walks off the right wing wall in the offensive zone. But Spinner finds Lawrence through center. He'll hurry across center, plays back in deep. Foley is there for Edina. Lawrence hounds him. Goose better hurry because here came Graham. And it was picked up by Spinner, cycled back in behind the Edina net. From the right corner as the goaltender roll call looks on. From the left point, shot wide of the cage. And now it's going to be gathered. They work the circle. There's a quick shot wide of the cage again. The carom comes out to the goaltender, Andrew Rollcall, but really started from the cycle of Steven Spinner off the left wing wall.
You are correct. And I think that when the Malmquist weight and Bellows line is out, Eden Prairie's had some pretty good success in the offensive zone. It just seems like they're trying to catch up with the play, Pete. That's not normal for this. But if they can take that line off its game, it makes it much easier to defend against this Edina Hornet team.
Graham and Fiddler in the faceoff circle. 10-19 to go. Clean draw. Spinner's shot was deflected by Masterman. Well wide of the Edina net. In the corner it goes. Out of the corner it comes. Spinner, a shot and a big save made there. From left to right of the butterfly was Rolko to steal that scoring chance from the low slot area.
Yeah, and it all started with Paul Meyer, the defenseman for the Edina on the left side. Tried to ring it off the glass. It hit one of the stanchions, went right back out. And he's a seamless glass here, but it hit something on the boards or the glass. Kind of made it a funny owly situation, but Rolko once again bails his team out.
Back up through center ice it goes. Here come the Hornets across the line. Fiddler had Munson misfired on the attempt there behind him as the puck goes to the corner. Nanny walks down from the slot. That Fiddler chance goes off the stick of Aguilar. And in the corner now it's going to be Mark Sullivan. Two-on-two battle. Graham is thinking about joining the fray as he stands off the side of the cage. Nanny from the right point hits Spinner in the skates with that one. Masterman tried to poke it through the defense, and back up the ice come the Eagles. What a battle here from Braemar Arena. Spinner wanted to make a move, but he couldn't on Paul Meyer, who made a great defensive play with the stick. From the left point, Snuggerud, Drister, Graham. Oh, he had the shot and a big save. And the rebound is turned aside by Rockhold. From the right side, Graham was patient. He had the wide open net. All he needed to go was short side shelf, and Rockhold shuts the door.
And he was efficient, too. Rokal did a good job of making himself big, but what a great opportunity for Eden Prairie that has to give him some energy, Pete.
Not a lot of panic there in Rokal's game during a dicey moment. 8:53 to go in the period. And up the left wing side, it's going to be Clays. He tries to work on the defense, but backside support by Munson. Terrific that forces a turnover. Now he gets it to the left wing. Fiddler on the backhand. Oh, and a paddle down save by the goaltender. That was a good one there by Gertis.
Well, it really started with a back check to Colin Munson. Once he took the Edina zone, Colin Munson actually stopped that. They turned in transition, came down. Munson had the puck just inside. Feathered a pass to Fiddler through the slot area. Tried to go five-hole on that one, but Gertis did a nice job of settling that one down. Boy, kind of a trying time for Eden Prairie. They dodged the bullet. Shots on goal now 15-11, favoring Eden Prairie, but Edina started to get some looks.
In on goal it goes, and that one was hung on to by Gertis.
Yeah,
he had great saves by both these goaltenders. Good scoring chances. Can't ask for much more.
Yeah, we're going to have a lot of choices for the save of the game, but he didn't win the faceoff. Got it back to Zwolsdorf. Good quick shot, but Gertis made it look easy.
Face off, puck fishes to the slot area. Gertis with a glove save right off the draw there.
That one not so easy, Pete. That one was going glove side, and it was just on top of the right hash mark. So they were in tight. Edina's getting it into that slot area. That's ultimately where you want your shots to come from. Edina's putting the faceoffs in the offensive zone. Eden Prairie's got to step up on the faceoffs, especially in their defensive zone, Pete.
Now we go to the left side of Gertis. As he stands in the basic stance and out of the zone come the Eagles with Snugger. He gains the checkered and plays back in deep. Zierzdorf is there. He has Argetsinger on him. Puck will be fished around to the right wing side. Alec Aistreich with an assist tonight off the skate to Koos. His pass is picked off at center by Snugger. He'll guide one to the left wing side and plays will turn it up. Runs into a check there by Koos. Colossal matchup there. Left wing side to Kroos as they try to play it up the wall. Bowlby comes over to try to help Zuhlsdorf as Argetsinger wins the battle of the corner. 7:45 to go in the second. 1-0 in favor of Edina. Zuhlsdorf off the backhand up high to the right winger. A strike, that's turned away, but Zuhlsdorf gathers into Bowlby from the left wing. Bowlby will walk it back behind the net. Power move in the goal mouth area. That goes through everyone, and it's plays to take over. He'll set it back to center, and on comes Nanny with full speed to the left wing. Cuts to the forehand, the right-hand shot. Holds it, shoots up high in the air, swatted down, and now it's Malmquist finds Nanny from the right circle. A shot and a save. A good one there by Gertis. Nanny tried to find Malmquist high. Clays is going to race Meyer to the loose change in the neutral zone. Jack Clays is fatigued. They'll head to the bench, and it's Malmquist across the line. Wait to the right wing, runs into a check by Sullivan, and a tripping call coming up on the leg that got out there.
Yeah, and that's going to be Mark Sullivan, junior defender, that's going to go for the Eden Prairie Eagles, and it was Dylan Malmquist or Garrett Wade that did a little drag move, just got his stick in the wickets, and now Eden Prairie is going to have to pick up their teammate. 71.7% penalty kill for Eden Prairie. Obviously looking to improve on that number, but the Edina's 10.9% power play, another number they're looking to improve on as well.
We talked about that in the pregame show, Bart Archer.
We did.
That's definitely a number. It hasn't really changed. It's gone from 7 to 10 to 11%. But never have we really seen it in the high numbers. Back in behind the net. Aguilar is going to ring the wall. Zuhlsdorf walks over. Looks to his right. Bellows plays low. Now it's Zuhlsdorf again. Nanny wanted a one-timer, failed the click, a little bit ahead of him. Power play for the Hornets for 127, 6:25 in the period, and they lead 1-0. Nanny's going to play down for Fiddler. Behind the net it goes. Malmquist with it. Malmquist hangs on. Nanny from the top of the left circle hits Keeley with that, the Eden Prairie winger. Hornets working it down low. And now it's Malmquist back up to Zuhlsdorf. Zuhlsdorf for Bellows. Cycles low for Malmquist. Now Nanny. Wrist shot, blocker pad save, and a good one by the goaltender Gertis. Now it's going to be Malmquist for Fiddler from the left hash marks. Low to Malmquist. Oh, Bellows. Now Nanny gets it back and puts that one in on goal. And that's turned aside. Hornets still work it. It's almost like surgery out here so far.
Yeah, Edina's very, very right-handed on the power play, but they like to bring it to the weak side. Tyler Nanny, generally the designated shooter on that. He got about four or five shots, and now the shots are tied 15 apiece. Edina flexing their muscles on this power play.
Now across the line, it's Fiddler as Graham comes away with it. 25 to go on the man advantage. I felt like I was in the old Forum in Montreal with the analyzing. Now spinner shorty, and that's a big save there. A beauty by Andrew Rocco.
Yeah, it really was. In fact, Gertis made probably three or four outstanding saves, and now Rocco called upon blockers and up and out of play, so the faceoff's going to be in the Edina zone. Just 14 seconds left in the penalty to Mark Sullivan, and then Eden Prairie, barring something unusual happening, can get back to 5-on-5 hockey. They've done a decent job of defending on this penalty kill, but Edina's getting some looks, and they'll probably have some residual energy from this power play as well.
Puck sits free. Munson is there as he comes away out of the circle. Let's see what ensues, as Bart suggested, after this power play is standing as Mark Sullivan. Now it's going to be Munson. Right wing on the outlet, through center they go. Masterman with speed, try to find Munson down low. As Sullivan is back on the ice with 4:51 to go here in the period. Dornbach winds and shoots, takes the goaltender up high. Curtis turns to the side of the blocker pad. Munson tried to cycle behind the net, but Snuggerud gets the position, and he can break away quickly. And he pulls away with the Jets across the Edina line. Luke Snuggerud with his 33 points to the corner. Tries to find Spinner, couldn't quite get the deal done, but here comes Graham to help out. To the right wing side it goes to Masterman, the Hornets in transition. Across center, Dornbach swats that one back into the Eden Prairie zone. And it's going to be Snuggerud. He has a man flying. Spinner didn't have enough juice on it. He had to come back at center to make the play, and Paul Meyer made a great play on Spinner to bring him down.
And just
Spinner looked at, Spinner looked at the official wanting a penalty there, I think. All sorts of jostling. Spinner and Meyer. Now there's a little stick between the legs by Spinner to Meyer. The old how's she going, as we like to say. In over the top of the goal. Spinner sends that one in. Nice shift by Paul Meyer to really keep the big fella in check. There's a shot steered out of there neatly by Rokol. Stick save. 3:40 to go in the period. Edina leads 1-0. Rister, traffic, plays, follow through. Blocked by Meyer down low in the goal mouth area. Puck will be rung to the wall. It's mismatched from the right wing side. He's going to guide it off the wall. Ooh, nice job. Aguilar, waist high, swatted it out of there with a base hit up the middle. Kurt Suzuki and pitchers and catchers reporting soon. Maybe Johan Santana too, you never know.
Not soon enough.
Back in behind the net. Boy, what's going on? Is Terry Ryan making good with all of Billy Smith's moves or what? He's like trying to rebuild just yesteryear to feel good. I'm not saying, I'm just saying. To the right wing side it goes. There's a wrist shot blocked wide of the cage. Mishandle there from center ice. Sullivan swings that one back into the Edina zone. Rokol will set up. 2:48 to go. This game is just flying by here. Putting out of the way is mismatch. Now it's going to be Nanny with it. Nanny will hold on to it, bump it off the boards for the corner. And the forecheck continues for the Eagles. Hornets again feeling as though they're bottled like they were in the start of the first period. They found Rosh at center, and Snuggerud made the play, but off the bench comes Malmquist. He'll turn it over at the Eden Prairie line, and up the ice they go. Michael Parrish shot it on goal, and the save made by Rokol.
Well, it was a pretty good job by Sam Foose really forced him to the outside. He didn't get the look that he wanted, but on top of the circle, he actually took a shot. But he went, tried to go five ball on that one. Rokol closed that gap in a hurry. Face up to his left. Just 2:12 left in this second period. United is still hanging on the one goal lead.
Danny now will outlet off the faceoff. It's going to be handled on the stick of Malmquist. Wanted to dangle, and Shu said no. Foose with it, plays rink wide for Zulsdorf wearing sweater number 5. Well, I can think of the great number 5s in Edina lore. Let's go to Matt Henches as one of them, the former Merrimack standout. A little size differential as that one goes off the blocker pad. About a foot, I would say, about a foot plus.
Yeah, in fact, but Zulsdorf, as you said, Pete, he's a very good player, and Henches wasn't his thing, let's give him the proper credit. But he's kind of a dispenser. He can actually get the puck to the people. Bellows had a pretty good look. Not a great look. He could have probably walked in a little bit, but tried to go blocker side. But nice job by Curtis, ramping up and out of play face off to his right.
Pulled back behind the Eden Prairie end as there's 1:42 to go. Looking to his right is the goaltender, Jake Curtis, looking to pick up his 10th win on the campaign. Right of the Dynanetic goes. It's going to be Foose with it. Finds Fiddler, right wing for Masterman. Speed up the wall. He's going to elect to jump and chase to the big control there. Boy, that's an National Hockey League got interference right there. Masterman dumps it in the corner, and Sullivan just takes him straight out. Letting him play here today at Braemar Arena, and we love it. Zulsdorf plays back in behind. 1:06 to go in the period. Puck is fished to the right wing wall for the Eagles out of the zone with Grant. Plays ahead for Lawrence, bumped off the wall. Spinner's going to play back in for the Eagles. Now Foose looks to his left. He's going to hurry to his right. Now Masterman again. His pass for Fiddler hits a pair of skates and plays, who has it poked off his stick very quickly by Fiddler. Fiddler now poked off his stick by Snuggery. Plays takes it. Who wants it? Fiddler does off the wall. The left-hand chop in the slot is blocked. Now Nanny from the left point. He had a man down low. Tyler Nanny, terrific vision. Could have taken the big shot, but instead he sees a man trolling in the low slot area with a nice hard pass that was nearly redirected in. In the Hornet zone it goes, back behind the net. Nanny right wing side for Masterman. Now it's going to be Malmquist across the line. Cuts to the forehand. Bellows was trolling. Now Nanny comes away with it. They'll say that was offside. Ooh, and odds from the peanut gallery.
Yeah, it didn't look like it was offside. It was offside by much, but he obviously in good proximity to make that call. But Pete, you talked about Tyler Nanny dishing that puck off. He came back and defended a one-on-one, and so he's played both angles, but I don't know if I've seen anybody with that quick of feet in many years, Pete. He could fly.
It's the lateral movement that is something you can't teach.
Crazy, he's crazy good.
Great vision and great competitive spirit to go with some solid hands. He has to be on the list of the top 10 for Mr. Hockey finalist, Bart Archer.
Do you think so? I think he's one of the most valuable players. He brings a different dimension to this Edina Hornet team.
You could have three out here with Spinner, Snuggerud, and Tyler Nanny.
Absolutely. Pretty impressive. I think Fiddler could be in that mix.
Could have been the short list too as well. Could be four.
Wow. A lot of talent.
Where do we stop? Score reads Edina Hornets 1, the Eden Prairie Eagles nothing. It's hockey night in Minnesota. High school hockey on Sports Radio 105. The ticket. We'll be back right after this. The Hornets lead by a score of 1-0 over the Eagles.
Great food and great sports. It's the Tavern on 4 and 5 in Eden Prairie. This season, the Tavern on 4 and 5 will be showing several PSB broadcasts of Eden Prairie boys hockey on the big screen TVs. So make it a night out. Get some great food and watch the EP boys hockey team at the Tavern on 4 and 5. Some of their classics include the Mediterranean Pizza, the Tavern Turkey Burger, and my personal favorite, the Cheesy Tater Tots. It's the Tavern on 4 and 5, located just blocks from Eden Prairie High School. Stay current on what's going on in your local community. The Sun Current is a local community newspaper that serves several communities in the Southwest Metro, including Eden Prairie, Edina, and Bloomington. The Sun Current will keep you up to date with the latest comings and goings on your school board, city council, arts and entertainment, and community events. And make sure you check out their in-depth high school sports coverage featuring weekly articles on Eden Prairie, Edina, Jefferson, and Kennedy. From football and hockey to tennis and swimming, the Sun Current has your favorite team covered. Keep it local and visit the Sun Current website at current.mnsun.com.
The playoffs are looming, and the impact of the regular season can take a toll on the body. At Performance Therapy Innovations, they can treat you or your Eagles for those nicks and ailments and help restore athletes physically and mentally for the most important time of the season. Performance Therapy Innovations will get you back to doing the things you love while minimizing your discomfort and maximizing your performance. Performance Therapy Innovations, helping Eagle athletes unleash their full potential. Located off Valley View Road and 169, online at pti-tc.com.
Jeepers, it's the Creeper!
What do we do now?
It's a mystery.
I know. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Zoinks! It's Lucy, like our favorite State Farm Major Lady.
Hi, gang. I'll handle it. And that's not really a monster.
Creeper!
Mr. Carswell!
You meddling kids.
State Farm takes the mystery out of dealing with insurance. Get to a groovier state.
Shop and save with Brandy Warmbier State Farm Insurance Office in Eden Prairie. A local connection at a lower cost. BrandyWarmbier.com.
Welcome back here to Braemar Ice Arena. We're at our second intermission with Edina ahead of Eden Prairie 1-0. As this game currently in terms of shots on goal, Eden Prairie leads 19-17 as Casey Dornbach picked up the only goal of the second period a few minutes in, as that's where we stand after two periods. Hornets turned up play in the second period after EP really had the better of the play back in the first period here in this one. Boy, this game is really, really gone fast. Not even 8:30 yet, and we're already through two periods. That's despite the fact that this game even started a little bit late, so I don't want to go away as this one's going fast. And looks like it's going to go straight down to the wire.
Yeah, welcome back to Kramer Arena, 1-0. The high school
hockey
game.
Seen a lot of great saves in the game from local and also at Jake Gertis, including that point-blank chance from Michael Graham, where he received a great pass from the point from Luke Snuggerud on the doorstep, but just couldn't get the puck in the air quite enough as it was a huge save for the Hornets.
It happened at the 2:33 mark of the first period. It was Casey Dornbach scoring his fourth
with Edina ahead of Eastbury.
And that's
by that 1-0 score. We'll take a timeout and have some out-of-town scores coming up next right here on PSB Media.
I'm Dr. Dennis Lenslink, Clinic Administrator and Patient Care Coordinator for Advocare Clinics, and I'd like to welcome you to our office. Advocare Clinics is considered an outpatient rehabilitation facility. We're pretty much one-stop shop. We offer wellness and prevention as well as acute pain and injury management. We have three distinct departments in Advocare. We have a physical therapy department, a chiropractic, wellness and prevention, and acupuncture department, and a medical procedure department. And the unique characteristic is how we combine those therapies. Our goal is to prevent surgeries or conditions getting worse. So one of our specialties is knee, hip, ankle, shoulder problems, where people are considering surgery. Many times we can then provide care that'll buy them 5 to 10 years of ongoing function with their original equipment, their own joints and shoulders. Our patients tell us that they like the attention to detail that we deliver in our therapies. Most of our patients give us a 7-plus score on a 1 to 10 scale, which means we're meeting a good amount of patient satisfaction based on your scores. Advocare's mission is to provide you a full and active lifestyle to the limits that you want, not what your body gives you.
Advocare Clinics, located off 494 and Highway 100, online at advocaremn.com.
Back here at Braemar Ice Arena, let's take a look at some out-of-town scores. Not too many updates to pass along to you. I do have Duluth East knocking off Lakeville South. That game has gone final already with the Greyhounds winning a 6-5. Other scores, Elk River's on top of Maple Grove, 2-1. That one actually has just gone final as Elk River apparently won that in overtime. Also have East Grand Forks beating Kitson County Central 3-0. And one other update for you, Northfield top Red Wing 3-0. Again, not too much else to update you on, but take a time out and have the third period on the way next year between Edina and Eden Prairie. Hornets on top of the Eagles, 1-0 on PSB.
season, just a few short weeks. We're getting after the girls. Well, their playoffs coming up very, very soon.
Boy, it's sure been a year that's flown by, Pete. A lot of surprises, a lot of things that we weren't planning on, but that's what makes this edition so exciting.
Now it's going to be Snuggerud who plays ahead into the neutral zone as we're back underway to start the third period. Thanks a lot for joining us here on Hockey Night Minnesota, a high school hockey game of the week, and that one's turned over. Fiddler bidding for a goal there for the Hornets as he's shut down. Wide of the cage it goes. Now it's Shue at center for the Eagles. Slaps that back in the Edina zone. Calmly it rolls along the right corner off to Rocco. As Spinner and Fiddler come together. And it's going to be handled off the right side of the cage. Fiddler's there. And now it's Graham with it. Does the Alf Dowling circus clown skate away from trouble? That's a good picture. Both of your heels, and you can go left, you can go right.
Yeah, Tyler Nanny shows that every once in a while.
He'll go off down circus pond. Absolutely. Longtime North Star fans will know exactly what we're talking about. When Alfie was in his office off the end boards. Speaking of office end boards, there's Fiddler with a chance that goes up over the top of the goal. It's going to be played back in behind. Shue for Snuggerud rolls the stick. Bellows a little. How's she going off the side of the net? Didn't connect with weight, and it's going to be picked up by Snuggerud through center. He's going to help that one back into the Edina zone as Nanny comes away. Ooh, gets away from one man. Quick turn from left to right. Now he's going to angle across the right wing side as he sends a pass for Waite. Mark Sullivan was there. Waite comes back down. Nanny wants it in the feet. Couldn't handle it as he plays that one through, and it's going to be picked up back out of the zone to the right wing side. Malmquist is there. Jostling comes away with it. Meyer will stretch it out. Right wing side. They go east-west to Waite. Paddle down, steered to the right by Gertis of the Eagles. It's going to be Aguilar for Clays. Try to find Argensinger. Waite picks it up and sends a shot in on goal. That's stopped there by Gertis and hung on to.
Well, very fortunate for Eden Prairie because, as you said, Pete, it was Garrett Waite who took that puck in the right circle after a giveaway by the Eden Prairie defender. Got a good look at the goal. Gertis came out and challenged that one, received it. No second chance, but kind of a trying moment for that Eden Prairie team. They got the ball. Face off to Gertis' left.
Possession owned by the Eagles as they play up the left wing side. One-handed through center, poked away by Foose. Eagles will once again regroup in their own zone with Snuggerud. Dornbach, the game's lone goal scorer on the puck, loses control, and it's A-Strike to play back in behind. Snuggerud was there. A-Strike, golden opportunity off the backhand as he tried to pull it to the forehand and lost the marble.
Got handcuffed.
Someone tossed the keys away. Bowlby with it. Plays back in behind for Foose. Looks to the right wing. Nobody home as they're going to play back through for Bowlby. He'll backpedal and play behind the net. Foose! Oh, what a pick by the official. Took Foose right out of the play. Eagles with possession. Aguilar with it. Swings that one and plays it down. And it's going to be controlled by the Eagles. This is all a result of Foose not being able to get through the official. Oh, and a fortunate break for the Eagles. That puck went in the net.
Oh, fortunate break for the Edina Hornets, Pete.
I mean the Edina Hornets, sorry.
No, no worries, but you're right. It all stems down to the referee not setting an intentional pick, but he actually impeded the progress of the Edina forward. Eden Prairie did a good job of moving the puck around, making Edina react to that, and then they got it in tight, but if the net didn't come off the mooring, he'd have a tie game right now, Pete.
Once again, the north side net creating all sorts of issues.
Never happens.
Oh, never ever. Puck played to the near wing as the Hornets will try to play behind the net and run around the wall. Munson, Aguilar comes down, and that's going to be taken away by Paul Meyer. He had a hurry, though, as it was Aguilar, very active. The footwork, speed, back check, and support of the Eden Prairie Eagles, very impressive here tonight. Masterman plays it in on goal, and Gertis is going to cover as they'll take the safety valve. 13:42 to go. Still 1-0 in favor of Edina.
And you're right. It's not just intermittent either. Eden Prairie's played a very consistent, solid game, and they seem to be getting back to where they were. Not a lot of action in front of the goals at this point, but there's a lot of north-south skating going on, so a pretty good flow going on right now.
Aguilar takes down Fiddler with good body position. Off the glass to center. Meyer slaps that, tries to get it deep, but can't. Hits traffic. Lawrence was there momentarily. Now it's going to be Munson with it across the line. Carries low. Shallow angle shot high off the glass. Carrying up high to the left wing. Not out, though, as Fiddler tries to play down low for Masterman. Munson is there. Now Masterman back up for Munson. They're going to cycle to the corner. Munson comes away off the end boards as he's being hounded on the play. And they'll still continue to battle. Munson looks for Fiddler. Poked back up to the line. Foley will have to hurry to the right side. Gets there, but up off the low ceiling here at Braemar Arena. And will face off inside the Eagle zone.
But one thing about the Miguel Fiddler is he's got to be a little bit more selfish, because you get in that shooting area, you have to take that shot. It's going to be an ugly goal. You can't rely on the highlight reel pass. Take the shot if you can get him. He's got to be a little more selfish. And he's got those quick hands, too. So, but again, he's done it pressing quite well in the offensive zone.
From the right wing side, it's played up out of the zone. Argot Singer is there. Nanny has it. Wait with it. Across center. In on goal. Steered aside by Gertis with the paddle down again. It's like a second coming of Eddie Belfort. Wait. Tries to shovel Malmquist off the right wing. Behind the net. Handled now by Snuggerud. The Hornets working the shutout with 12:30 to go. Sorry, Hornet fans. I didn't mean to jinx it. Zulsdorf,
oh,
and a nice glove save made by Gertis.
Well, Zulsdorf was actually being pressed by Meter on that one. Got a good quick wrist shot off, but that one had some velocity. Took it to the glove side, but Gertis really a good-looking goalie. Good positioning on that one. Snared that one. Otherwise, we might be talking about Edina Grove. Face off to his right, 12:23 left. Edina still up by one.
Flared the glove with authority, Bart Archer.
Indeed he did.
Now it's Snuggerud with it. As he looks to the left wing, Keeley kind of fans on it, gets a little bit of help along the way. Michael Parrish was there. Now it's Keeley looking for Parrish. Zulsdorf advances ahead for Bowlby too far, and there's Snuggerud with a nice play to keep in from the right point. Never score! We're tied at one. Big goal scored there by Eden Prairie's Jack Sullivan off the turnover.
Yeah, and it all started on the dump in. Eden Prairie actually won the battle of the puck in the offensive zone and really got it out to Jack Sullivan. Jack Sullivan looped that one glove side for his seventh goal of the year, but boy, what a great shot that was. But great effort on the forecheck by Eden Prairie, putting down it back on their heels, and Eden Prairie got rewarded with some hard work. Now we're tied at one, 12:03 left in regulation time.
Yikes, I think I did jinx that part, Archer. So 5 minutes into this third period, we're tied at one. Wouldn't expect anything less between these two teams. They've been going tooth and nail here from Braemar Arena. We're tied at one, Bart Archer. And that goal scored by Zach Sullivan was his seventh of the season. Picks up his 16th point.
And the assist goes to Parrish and Sealer. Time of the goal, 4:57.
Annie with it, gives off for Zulsdorf through traffic. Here's an opportunity. Score!
Oh, boy.
Fiddler peels it off the end wall and buries it for the 2-1 lead.
So it was Fiddler that took that shot and moved the goaltender Gertis. Now he's had it back to that one-goal push again. But again, it looks like it's a pretty wide-open third period. You kind of thought it would be. I don't think we're done yet.
With the hands there by Fiddler off the end, where it's left in the backhand. Got it to the forehand at plenty of time. And then buried it behind a wide-open net as Gertis was trying to come over from right to left. Little tardy getting there on the Hornets center iceman made sure he made good on that tally. And for Fiddler, that's goal number 15 on the season. He has it again. Does Fiddler over the top, and then he hit the Wyzetta banner over the Eden Prairie goal. Down goes Gertis, but looks like he'll be okay. So all that work for the Eagles, they do what they can to come back to tie this thing at one, and now they trail by a score of 2-1.
Yeah, official scoring is Fiddler is 15th from Zulsdorf and Tyler Danny at 5:18. So really, Pete, just about 21 seconds later, he got an answer. That's what good teams can do. But boy, it's anybody's ball game from this point. But he kind of has that one goal cushion again.
And here come the Eagles looking to get right back to where they were. Tied with the Edina Hornets as the one goal margin continues. Shots on goal read 25-20 in favor of the Hornets. Now it's Waite, whose pass is blocked by the sliding defense. And it's going to be Snuggerud back up ice through the middle. That hits Nanny on its way through. Arkensinger, a snapper, hits traffic. Zuhlsdorf lost the handle. Looks like his hand isn't doing too well either. Now it's Snuggerud, left point, sends one through. That hits Nanny, trickles wide of the cage. Arkensinger works on Zuhlsdorf, plays back behind the net for Nanny from the right side. Angles ahead for Malmquist, neat pass there. Malmquist gives to Bellows. Bellows plays back toward the slot area, and it's going to be Snuggerud walking away from the stick of weight. Snuggerud with it. Loses the biscuit at the line. I think he did that one on his own, Bart Archer.
I think you're right.
Or it hit the snow as it likes to pile up. We don't get the shovels and shovel the whole darn ice like they do in the show. Here's a chance for Keeley. Tries to slice through the defense. Puck trickles to the end wall in the Hornet zone. Now it's going to be Bellows. Sends some sauce to the right wing side for A-Strike. Couldn't handle. Played right back in as Foley will play. 9:58 to go in the period. 2:29 at Dornbach. Has the game's first goal. Now Bellows will let the shot go. That hits Aguilar, who plays that one ahead. Now Foley hits Aguilar again. Or check that. That's Jack Sullivan back up out of the zone. And Aguilar will regroup. He has Mark Sullivan to his left. Ops to the right. As the Eagles will play back into the Edina zone. No icing on the play. Foley with it. 9:34 to go. Left wing. Checked off the play was Bowlby, and it's going to be Meyer to play ahead. Bowlby swats at it, comes away, wins the battle of the sticks at center. High over the glass. In the Eden Prairie zone it goes. Carrom to the right point, played back in by Dornbach behind the net. Now it's Snuggerud there, down in a heap goes Bowlby, and it's going to be Spinner with it from the left wing side. He'll pick up ahead of steam off the wall for Parrish, or Graham rather, that too far, and icing your call.
Well, pretty good representation by the Hornets. We got the Dornbach A-Strike and, things that happened in Bowlby. A very effective line for Edina. That's their third unit, but if they come out and be relevant to the offensive zone, that really opens things up quite a bit, presents a challenge for Lee Smith. They've been very effective all night when called upon.
Conference down in the circle. They're going to take this one outside, Bart.
Yeah, they're going to bring it to center ice as far as that goes. So probably an error by the official on that one. So they're just going to bring it to center ice. Shots on goal, 25 for Edina, 20 for Eden Prairie. So Edina's really mounting the shots up, especially in this period so far.
Lawrence plays ahead through traffic. The Spinner Lawrence Graham line matching up to the Edina one. It should be Fiddler Hudson Asterman. Shots along the sideboards at center. Back into the Eden Prairie zone it goes. It's going to be Shue to gather in the loose chain. He'll bump off the wall for Snuggerud. Shue is collected neatly by Munson, but the Eagles with possession. Graham had his pass taken away. Instead gives off to the right side to Snuggerud, who slides underneath the Munson check. Helped back into the Edina zone. It's going to be Nanny trying to outlet to the right wing side, but ran into trouble in the Eden Prairie Eagles. Through center ice, it's Masterman with it. Stood up by Shue. Masterman there, plays along the left wing wall. Niederer gets ahead, and here comes Graham with speed looking for help. Doesn't have anybody. He's going to create. Nice play as he shows it to the forehand and tucks it to the backhand and walked in with an opportunity for the Hornets defense. Manny with it now, plays ahead. This tough sledding out on the ice, folks. There's not a lot of room to work. These teams are defensively sound here tonight.
And they needed to be. Cullen Munson and Snuggerud have been going at it all game long, and they just had one of those shifts where it got awful muddy between those two.
Icing the call as Argensinger trying to angle one off the wall. Bart was about 3 feet south of the center red line, and that's going to be an icing call.
Yeah.
You know, really from a playoff style perspective, okay, with the discipline of the zones and their defensive zone coverage, you toss the result out. I think both coaches have to be really pleased with the way these two teams are playing this stage of the season.
Yeah, they're not quitting on plays, Pete. Everything is being finished. Everything is being exhausted until there's no other option available. It's been very impressive so far.
From the center red, it's going to be Foos from right to left, angling that one back in. And it's going to be the Hornets now cycling behind for Malmquist, who tries to find a play to Foos up to the point. Niederer off him, didn't know where it went. That hits Clays. Where is it? Boy, nobody can seem to find the puck. It's up in the air. It's all over the place. Now it's center. Right wing pass. They're going to spring Clays on the right side and on goal, and that's a stop made by Rokel. 7:10 to go in a very tight third period.
Yeah, time is going to start being a little bit of an issue for the Eden Prairie Eagles. Edina's putting some shots up on the board, getting a lot of offensive zone time, but Eden Prairie certainly not out of it by any stretch. They're getting their moments, but if they get a moment, they have to find a way to solve this road ball riddle, and so far they've done it once, but they need to do it again. But 7-10, there's still plenty of time, but once it gets down to the 3-4 minute mark, then it becomes more of a concern.
Spinner to shoe off the faceoff, snugger with right side. Ooh, that deflects. Volkow makes a nifty little stick save there.
Didn't miss by much.
Back up for shoe. Gets away from the oncoming Masterman as he plays it to the left wing boards. For the Hornets, winger will make the play and get back to center with it as it's Lawrence for Snuggerud. Snuggerud to the left wing. Now at his own line, it's going to be Spinner to play a rink-wide pass for Shue. Lawrence at the Edina line plays back in. Manny wanted to take Shue. The defenseman for the Eagles caught down low as he races back up, makes a play off the stick. Lawrence with it to the backhand, wanted to play it up high. Look out, here comes Fiddler in on goal with a breakaway. Fiddler got the save made by Gerdes.
Well, very opportunistic Miguel Fiddler on that one. Took a little bit of an errant pass. Reed Perry in his own zone, streaked down. Snuggery couldn't catch up. I think the puck rolled him a little bit, but he tried to go backhand on that one. But Gerdes did a good job of tracking that puck. Not challenging too much, just enough. But what a big save that is. That might be something we might refer to in about 3 or 4 minutes, but what a big save that was.
Well, we're putting that into the mix as a possible save of the game. How about that?
Wasn't flashy, but it was sure effective.
All right, Archer. Okay, maybe I'll take it off the list then. Up the right wing side, because we're all flash, no substance here on the high school hockey game of the week.
And now we're just 6 minutes and 2 seconds left in regulation time, and another offensive zone faceoff. It looks for the Edina Hornets. You can't tempt fate too many times, but Eden Prairie wins the faceoff, gets out clean, no harm, but you can't tempt Edina too many times in an offensive zone faceoff. They've been too successful on faceoffs tonight.
Dornbach to take the draw for the Hornets. He goes in against Michael Parrish. Up in the air, Gerdes waits for it right into the big catch glove. He'll hang on. The faceoff comes up to his right.
Yeah, in fact, it is good job by Dornbach to win that faceoff and actually put the puck toward the goal, but that's what we were speaking of. Eden Prairie's got to have more success in their own zone.
Bowlby plays back in behind. Keeley comes down. Big check. Fails to click there. Losing Oz for the peanut gallery. Keeley, neat pass to him through center with speed. He carries down to the left corner. That goes off Bruce, off the glass, and now from the left corner, neat breakout from Foley to Dornbach up the middle. Dornbach at the line, snapper in on goal. Nice little blocker pad saved there by Gerdes. Hornets will work hard off the end line. 5:22 to go in what I feel is the fastest moving high school hockey game of the year. Keeley through center ice, Malmquist submarines him. Rolko's going to opt to hang on to that one and will face off to his left.
Well, and I think that he wasn't really threatened, but I think the method of thought was get the fresh legs out on the ice as much as you can. 5:11, so we're just above the 5-minute mark left in regulation. If a goaltender has a chance to possess the puck, chance you're good, they're going to freeze it, but it allows the coaches to put the proper matchups up if Kirk Giles has the last line change.
Dark, good to hear our old bandmate Dugger Lean listening in.
Oh, Dugger.
Hope all's well with you, my friend. We miss you. You need to be out here with us. Let's just leave it at that.
Get the band back together.
Absolutely. Little reunion tour.
Yep. I'm in.
Well, as long as Yoko Yoko Ono stays home with Sean, I'm happy.
I'll play the triangle.
Boy, that's some of the most painful television watching I've seen. Back at center ice it goes. What was worse? The awkward shots between Yoko Ono and Sean Lennon? We're watching Steven Tyler, the only guy in a white tuxedo, trying to dance soulfully. They're going to play it to the right wing side. Bart, you missed it. It was classic. I was in full meltdown. Wide of the Edina cage it goes. Rocco is there. And now it's going to be Fiddler. 4.5 to go. Fiddler at the line. Has it poked off his stick, but Munson supports and plays it down low. Down goes an Eagle player as the Eden Prairie bench goes berserk looking for a call, but they're not going to get it. Graham with it across center, plays that one back in behind the net. Meyer will wait, gathers in the puck to his left, plays back behind for Nanny, the safety valve, but then there's going to be Meyer to take back over. Chip back up into the center ice area. Stood up on the play as Rosh. 3:55 to go in the period. Plays with it. Ahead for Argensinger. He has Niederer angling through center. They're going 2-on-4 there, 2-on-5. Good luck with that. And here come the Hornets back out of the zone. Malmquist straight up the middle. Shovels a pass for Rosh to the left wing side. Rosh has taken Bello's slot on this line, at least for the moment. As now it's going to be Malmquist. And in on goal, that's stopped neatly there by Gerda.
Yeah, good battle down there by Argensinger and Malmquist. And then when the puck squirted away and scored the goal, so I think with Gerda did a good decision by increasing that puck, letting them get fresh legs out of the ice. 27 left, another offensive faceoff for the Edina Hornets, and they win that draw again.
Down the corner it goes, off the glass. Zuhlsdorf with it. Dornbach swings at the puck, 3:15 to go. Crunch time starting to become a factor here from Braemar Arena. Eagles trail by 2-1 as the Hornets pick up a second period here and a third period goal. Fiddler scores just seconds after the Eagles tied it up at 1. Off the glass, gathered up out of the corner. Here come the Eagles on it now as Jack Sullivan. And the turnover, Sullivan gets it back. He's alone, just throws it toward the net area, hits Goose. Sam Goose has been really solid on the blue line for Edina tonight.
It really has. So is Meyer.
Fiddler, not flashy, but effective. Now it's going to be Lawrence. Turns it back up ice. 2:33 to go. Still 2-1. Lawrence shot. Oh! Rocco lost the vision on that puck, as did yours truly. I thought it was coming more toward the net. Aguilar shot, a hard one on the ice, doesn't get through. Players were moving toward the slot area, but the Hornets were clear to center. Aguilar to the near side, left wing. Mark Sullivan gives away for Spinner across the line. Quick wrist shot, and steered up and out of play by Rolfo.
Yeah, Spinner gained the zone and tried to use Sam Poos as a screen, put it between Poos's legs, and good shot on goal, but Rolfo cracked that puck quite well, ramped it up and out of play, face up to his right. 2:08 left in this regulation time in this game. Edberg's going to have to start taking some chances, whether he's holding a defenseman and holding the zone a little longer, but they have to start getting to Rolfo. Looks like they're getting there, but they have to finish the play.
Spinner was there as that's off the heel of his stick. Nanny plays up, and it's going to be Waite. Shue comes away with it. He's going to play back over for Snuggerud. He tries to drag in the forechecker. Rosh can't get away from him, though, as it's going to be handled by Malmquist across the line. Waite now. Checked off his stick, and it. Argensinger tried to play it through. Snuggerud instead hurries away from traffic. Tried to get through some sticks. Couldn't. The Hornets are all over him. Now it's Malmquist. He's dangerous. Shooting and a pad save. Curtis keeps it a one-goal game with a minute and a half left. We'll keep our eye on him. Keeley with it now from the left wing. Now it's Meyer back in behind the net. He loses the handle but plays it to safety. Pinching down to Snuggerud to the corner. Gerdes is at the hash marks midway in the slot. 5-on-5. Snuggerud shot. Pad save. Big one there by Rocco. Now Snuggerud will watch as Rosh will gain the center red and play it in deep. No, he didn't. Icing is the call. That was awfully close.
Well, it was still a good play because the puck looked like it wasn't going to clear the zone. He's probably going to come back with pressure. But again, if an icing is the worst thing that can happen, at least they can get fresh line changes, get fresh legs out there. And Gerdes is out of the net now with an offensive zone face-up for the Seton Prairie Eagle team. This last minute, 4 seconds, is going to be awful exciting, but I think roll call. Timeout is called. Good time for a timeout. Make sure everybody's settled down on the same page. But I think roll call is going to have to come up with a very, very...
The playoffs are looming. And the impact of the regular season can take a toll on the body. At Performance Therapy Innovations, they can treat you or your Eagles for those nicks and ailments and help restore athletes physically and mentally for the most important time of the season. Performance Therapy Innovations will get you back to doing the things you love while minimizing your discomfort and maximizing your performance. Performance Therapy Innovations, helping Eagle athletes unleash their full potential. Located off Valley View Road and 169, online at pti-tc.com.
Jeepers, it's the creeper! It's a mystery.
I know. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Zoinks! It's Lucy, like our favorite State Farm agent lady.
Hi, gang. I'll handle it. And that's not really a monster.
Creeper!
Mr. Carswell!
You meddling kids.
State Farm takes the mystery out of dealing with insurance. Get to a groovier state.
Shop and save with Brandy Warmbier State Farm Insurance Office in Eden Prairie, a local connection at a lower cost. BrandyWarmbier.com.
Take the draw. We have, we see Snuggerud, Argus Singer plays. Graham will join the fray. And Spinner. He's going to have Spinner for the shot. They're going to put the pressure on Michael Graham to win the draw. Of course, his brother Patrick.
But no red Margaret.
Yep. Snuggerud, big draw by Graham, back up behind. Argus Singer comes with it, and we have less than 1 minute remaining, down to 55 seconds. Gets Muddy a long roll pull off the side of the cage as things come together. No harm, no foul.
Well, I think Eden Prairie did well by winning the faceoff, getting it back to Snuggerud, but Snuggerud, with good pressure from the Edina forwards, just dumped it back in, but Eden Prairie maintained possession, tried to get it back out into that scoring area, but a roll call, good decision to hold on to that one. Now they reset. Eden Prairie's got to win this faceoff.
They got the first one of the Graham. He and Fiddler did battle the first time round. Here we go for round two. See if we toss somebody. No, we're not. We're going to be all right. There's a lot of movement on the backside. Another clean draw. Snuggerud with it. Wrister traffic. Wide of the cage. Graham was there. Body taken by Clay. So they're going to let him play on. Could have been a hold. That one wide of the net. And now it's Danny trying to shovel. Oh, and that one gets Snuggerud. They'll say it's off him. No icing. Goodness gracious. 32 to go. Snuggerud is there in his own zone. He's who you want to have the puck. Gets away from a Munson stick check. Now it's Snuggerud. He's going to work the hard ring, and it's going to be picked up by Sullivan. Jack Sullivan and Meyer to the corner. 18 seconds on the clock. Snuggerud shovels the back end. Down low it goes to the corner. Picked off by Nanny. To the glass. Spinner is there. Tried to play over for Snuggerud, and Munson's just going to play to safety. 5 seconds to go. Plays will turn it back up ice. Fans on the opportunity. Center, and that'll do it. As the Edina Hornets hang on and win a well-fought 2-1 battle here from Braemar Arena.
Well, indeed it was, Pete. I think both coaches have to be feeling pretty good about the way their team played. Obviously, Lee Smith and the Eden Prairie Eagles are a little disappointed they didn't come out of here with the win, but they certainly played well enough to get the win. But the Edina Hornets didn't play their best game, but showed the resiliency that good teams can do to come back and answer just 21 seconds after being scored on to tie. So, pretty good.
All right, well, that'll do it here from Braemar Ice Arena as Edina tops Eden Prairie 2-1. Stay tuned. We're going to have the Sun Current postgame show on the way next.
The Sun Current is proud to be your community news leader for over 50 years. Each week, you can read their in-depth coverage on local government, school district news, high school sports matchups, community events, and newsmakers. The Sun Current's website is now mobile user-friendly and provides breaking local news coverage daily. Check it out at current.mnsun.com.
Welcome back here to Braemar Ice Arena. We're on the Sun Current postgame show. The Sun Current is your community news source for over 50 years here in the Southwest Metro area, as they provide news on everything from politics, school board news, also high school sports and other community events. Find more information at current.mnsun.com, and they're also now mobile user-friendly, so you can take a look at the Sun Current's websites on different mobile devices. So Edina wins this one 2-1 over Eden Prairie here from Braemar Ice Arena. Well-played game from both teams. I think if you were to talk to Coach Lee Smith, wouldn't be disappointed with the way his team played today, especially in that first period where they really were able to up the pressure. The problem was they weren't able to get a goal in that first period, and that pressure didn't come through, and that's what hurt them, as well as also some very strong goaltending from the goaltender Rocco as well. From Edina, who had a very solid game. Shots on goal for the game were 30-25 in favor of Edina in this one. Let's give you a scoring summary briefly. Edina got on the scoreboard with the only goal of the second period as Casey Dornbach scored at 2:33. It was an even strength goal. And then in the third period, Eden Prairie tied things up momentarily on a Jack Sullivan goal at 4:57. But less than 30 seconds later, Miguel Fiddler put the Hornets back up 2-1, as that was the final score, 2-1 Edina. Special teams, just one power play in the game was to Edina, and they failed to score. So a pretty clean game between these two rivals, as again, Edina comes out on top 2-1 over Eden Prairie. I'd like to thank all of our sponsors for tonight's game, including the Tavern on 4 and 5, the Mulch Store, Performance Therapy Innovations, BECTV, Advocare Clinics of Minnesota, Home Video Studio, and Brandy Warmbier's State Farm Insurance Office. Make sure you tune in on Saturday as we'll have coverage of Eden Prairie at Wyzetta. That will be a 7 o'clock game here on PSB. For everyone here that brought you tonight's broadcast, thanks for tuning in and have a good night.
Thanks for tuning in to live local play-by-play coverage of Eagles High School Sports. Tonight's broadcast was brought to you by Umbria Gourmet Pizzeria, The Mulch Store, Alpha Investment Advisors, Performance Therapy Innovations, Brandy Warmbier State Farm Insurance Office, and Healthy Training. Keep it tuned to PSBMN.com for more broadcasts of Eagles High School Sports.